Today I am going to discuss about stringing chart, frag template and the conductor vibration. The stringing chart, it is the plot of tension versus temperature, and sag versus temperature is called as stringing chart. That is, x axis is taken for the temperature, y axis is taken for tension in kg as well as sag in meter. The stringing chart is used for knowing the how much the sag and tension at any temperature level. In the atmospheric condition, the temperature is not constant throughout the year. Based upon the climate condition, the temperature should be changes. Based upon the temperature, the sag and tension, it should be varied. For preparation of stringing chart, the first we need to calculate it. What is the sag and tension of the conductor under worst condition, that is under final state? The sag is the difference of two supporting structure, that is either pole or tower, and lowest point of the conductor is called as sag. Lowest point of the conductor is called as sag. At the time of erection of the conductor, they are given for the small amount of dip or small amount of sag without damage of the conductor, without interruption of the conductor. Based upon the temperature and based upon the tension, the sag occurred is more. The sag occurred is more. That is how we can calculate it, means that is this plot tension with respect to the temperature and sag with respect to the temperature. Here, the stringing value of the line conductor, the mainly depends upon, these are the five parameters. One is height of the structure, size of conductor, operating voltage of the line, span length, atmospheric condition. If the structure height, that is height of the tower, this the sag and tension, it should be differed for distribution line as well as for the transmission line. For distribution purpose, the supporting structure we are used for poles, that is at present we are used for the RCC pole, reinforced cement concrete pole. For transmission purpose, we are used for the towers, that is 66 kV, 132 kV, 220, 400 and 765 kV, the supporting structure we are used for tower. Based upon the height of the structure, the stringing value it should be changed. The stringing value it should be changed. Second one, size of the conductor. Actually, the conductors are classified for four types: solid conductor, standard conductor, hollow conductor, and then bundle conductor. Here, the sag template, that is the stringing chart, it should be differed based upon the size of the conductor, based upon the diameter. Generally, we are used for the ACSR conductor. And operating voltage of the line. For low operating voltage, this effect is less. For higher operating voltage, the effect is more. In AC transmission line, once the operating voltage is increased, means more number of conductors are required. That is, we are used for the bundle conductor, more than one conductor per phase. That is, for 220 kV, we are used for two conductor per phase. For 400 kV, we are used for three conductor per phase. For 765 kV, we are used for four or six conductor per phase. And span length, that is one supporting structure to another supporting structure, if the span length is increased, means tension as well as for the sag is also increased. And atmospheric condition, in open atmospheric condition, that is in the hilly area or crossing of the river, lake, at present the tension is more. The tension is more. In the closed area, the tension it should be more. These are the various major factor depending upon the stringing chart, that is height of the structure, size of the conductor, operating voltage of the line, span length, atmospheric condition. Atmospheric condition. These are the stringing charts. Next one, sag template. It is a very convenient way of locating the towers. It is at different height. It consists of the four thing. One is for the hot template curve or hot curve, ground clearance curve, tower curve or support foot, hold curve or uplift curve. This is the minimum clearance, means ground level to the up to the lowest point of the conductor, that is represent for minimum clearance. The remaining is at the time of erection, we are given for the small amount of dip or sag, small amount of dip or sag. After 6 months or after 1 year, automatically the sag is appeared based upon the various conditions. One is for based upon the temperature, the sag is created. And second one, based upon the tension. Here the tension is concentrated for two weight. One is for the conductor weight, another one is for the wind velocity or wind force. The conductor weight is presented for the vertical direction and wind velocity is presented for the horizontal direction. This the sag template is usually made up of transparent celluloid, perplex or sometimes cardboard. That is, these are the various curve. One is for the hot curve or hot template curve, ground clearance curve, tower curve, otherwise the support foot. Another one is for cold curve or off-lit curve. This the hot template curve, or that is simply represent for the hot curve. It is plotting the sag at maximum temperature. The sag at maximum temperature. In this atmospheric condition, the maximum temperature is there, elaborated. That the curve is represent for the hot curve against the span length. Against the span length. This the support must be located to maintain the prescribed ground clearance. The ground clearance in the sense that is ground level to the lowest point of the conductor. That is, the sag is represent for the difference of two supporting structure and the lowest point of the conductor. This particular point to up to the ground level. This is represent for the minimum clearance. Otherwise, it is represent for the ground clearance. This is represent for hot curve. The second one, ground clearance curve. It is lowest of the hot curve or hot template curve, parallel to the hot curve. It is below the hot curve, drawn parallel to hot curve at vertical distance equal to ground clearance or minimum clearance as prescribed by regulation of the given length. That is, from one supporting structure to the another supporting structure, the span length is there. We are considered there is a span length. That ground clearance curve is below the hot curve, drawn parallel to the hot curve. And the third one is represent for tower curve. The another name is represent for the support foot. This is for the support foot or tower curve. It is drawn for locating the position of the supports for tower line. That is, this is for the tower line, support of the tower line. And parallel to the other, that is parallel to other means one is for the hot curve, another one is for the ground clearance curve, maintaining a vertical distance of a standard tower. That is, from ground level to the some amount of the standard height is there. That is considered for the tower curve. And the last one is represent for the cold curve, otherwise it is represent for the uplit curve. That is normal sine wave. It is obtained by plotting the sag at minimum temperature without wind pressure against the span length. Without wind pressure against the span length. This is represent for the sag template. The sag template consists of the four things following parameter. One is for the hot curve, ground clearance curve, tower curve, another one is for the cold curve. The next one, conductor vibration. At the time of erection, we are given for this is the two supporting structure, either pole or tower. At the time of erection, we are given for the small amount of dip or sag. That is, we can maintain the without damage of the conductor due to the conductor weight as well as for the wind velocity. After 6 months or after 1 year, automatically the sag is occurred. This is we don't know. Based upon the temperature, climate condition, all the metallic body, it should be extended based upon the temperature. Here we are used the material is called as ACSR conductor. That is aluminum conductor, steel reinforced. That is the aluminum, based upon the temperature, it should be extended. In a year, 365 days, the temperature is not maintained for same. In that, based upon the climate condition, some of the time, the conductor it should be elaborated. And one more thing, based upon the weight, the two weight is there. One is for the conductor weight, another one is for the wind velocity, that is wind weight. The conductor weight is presented for the vertical and the wind velocity is presented for the horizontal. That the effect is weight of the conductor, another one is based upon the temperature. Once the sag is occurred more, this small amount of the wind pressure, the conductor is vibrated. That is concentrated for the normal swing. Once the conductor is vibrated, the current is actual, the current flowing in the conductor is sine wave. Once the conductor is vibrated, the current is concentrated for the non-sinusoidal wave. Due to that, the charging current is affected. That is, IC is affected. That is, IC already we know that the charging current IC equal to 2 pi FC into V phase. That is, the charging current is directly proportional to the capacitance. The charging current is directly proportional to the capacitance. Once the charging current is affected, capacitance is also changed. But already we know that the transmission line parameter, that is resistance, inductance, and capacitance, it should be maintained for constant from starting point up to the ending point. That is, from generating station to the receiving substation, or receiving substation to the consumer premises. This is the major problem due to the conductor vibration. The second one, resonant vibration. The another name is present for ILN vibration or high frequency oscillation. This is the maximum if the sag occurred is more. If the sag occurred is more due to the wind pressure, the resonant vibration is occurred. Here in this, the resonant vibration, it is vertex phenomena. The wind, the speed is 6 to 20 kilometer per hour. 6 to 20 kilometer per hour. It is connected in the transmission line. That is for 220 kV, 400, and then 765 kV. Here in the tower, the clamp is there, the supporting of the conductor. Supporting of the conductors. And the weight we are fixed. For 132 kV transmission line, for 132 kV transmission line, the damper weights, that is, we are used for the 5 kg weights without avoiding the vibrations. For example, we can take the 765 kV. In a single phase, it consists of 4 conductor. Without vibration, they are used for the clippings. Without vibration, they are used for the clippings. Nearer to the tower, nearer to the towers, they are added the weighting, that is damper weight, without vibrating. Third one is the dancing vibration or galloping or low frequency oscillation. If beyond the actual temperature or beyond the tension, if the small amount of the wind pressure, all the conductors, it should be close to each other. All the conductors, it should be close to each other. That is represent for dancing vibration or galloping or low frequency oscillation. Here the frequency is up to 3 mm. The frequency is 1 to 2 hertz. The frequency is 1 to 2 hertz. And the numerical problems of the sac, that is, the supports are at equal span length, supports are at unequal span length, wind and then ice formation. These are the various formula. The working tension we can calculate it. It is defined as the ratio of ultimate strength with respect to the safety factor. Ultimate strength, the another name is tensile strength. Otherwise, working tension T equal to ultimate strength into area of cross section by safety factor. We need to calculate it total height. That is, for unequal the span length, one is for the lowest side of the conductor, another supporting is called as the highest side of the supporting structure. Now, the sag is the difference between the two supporting structure and the lowest point of the conductor. This is represent for the sag. For lowest supporting structure, the sag is represent for S1, and highest supporting structure, the sag is represent for S2. The difference of S2 and S1, this is represent for H. That is, H equal to ground clearance plus sag. Ground clearance, otherwise the minimum clearance, ground level to the up to the lowest point of the conductor, this is ground clearance or minimum clearance plus sag, that is S1. This is called as height of the H, total height. And the next one, weight of the conductor. You need to calculate it. Actual weight of the conductor, it is product of cross-sectional area, 100 centimeter, and then specific gravity. The conductor area is pi d square by 4. And here two sag is there. One is for the horizontal sag or decline sag or clamp sag. Another one is for vertical sag. The vertical sag is S into cos theta. That is S in the sense, this is for the horizontal sag. And cos theta is W by WT. Actual weight of the conductor to the resultant weight of the conductor. For example, here the two weight is there. One is for the actual weight of the conductor is represented for W. The wind velocity, that is the wind force weight, is represented for WW, and formation of ice is represented for WI. Here, the actual weight of the conductor is presented for the vertical downwards, and the ice weight is also presented for the vertical downwards, and the wind weight is presented for the horizontal. We need to take for the resultant weight, that is represented for WT, that is WT equal to square root of W plus W I whole square plus WW whole square. WW whole square. Suppose in the problem they are given only the weight of the conductor and the wind weight. We can take WT, that is total weight of is or resultant weight, WT equal to W square plus WW square. And the wind force per meter length, we can take the wind velocity or wind force, WW equal to what is the wind pressure, projected area in meter square. And we can calculate the diameter of the conductor, square root of 4 into area by pi, otherwise cross sectional area divided by pi by 4. And go through the problem. And over a transmission line as a span of 220 meter, conductor weighing 804 kg per meter, calculate the maximum sag if the ultimate tensile strength of the conductor is 5,758 kg. Assume safety factor of 2, ground clearance 10 meter. Calculate the height at which conductor should be separated. Go through the problem. In the problem, they are given the data and over a transmission line, but in the problem they are not mentioned operating voltage, that is either 132 kV, 220, 400 or 765 kV. Over a transmission line means the system is for three phase system as a span of 220 meter. Here they are given for the span length 220 meter, that is one supporting structure to another supporting structure, that is one tower to another tower. They are given the span length is 220 meter. The conductor weighing, they are given the actual weight of the conductor, that is W equal to 804 kg per kilometer. 804 kg per kilometer. Calculate the maximum sag. Here we want to calculate how much is the sag. Calculate the maximum sag. If the ultimate strength of the conductor, they are given the ultimate, the strength is 5,758 kg. Assume a safety of 2, that is they are given the safety factor F equal to 2, and ground clearance 10 meter, that is ground clearance, another name is for minimum clearance. Calculate the height at which conductor should be supported. Here the first primary thing we need to calculate it for the sag. The second one we need to calculate it for the height at which conductor should be supported. That is, height at which conductor supported is minimum clearance or ground clearance plus sag. That is, here they are not represented equal span length or unequal span. If in the problem they are not mentioned, means defaultly you can take equal span length. That is S equal to W into L square by 80. W into L square by 80. Here in this problem, they are given the data is span length 220 meter, weight of the conductor 804 kg per meter. But here the span length is represented in terms of meter. The conductor is also represented in terms of meter. That is, they are given kg per kilometer, converted kg per meter. That is 1 kg is 10 to the power of 3. It goes to the numerator, 10 to the power of minus 3. Here we want to find out the sag, that is maximum sag, yes. And they are given ultimate tensile strength 5,758 kg, safety factor is 2, ground clearance 10, as well as we need to find out height at which conductor should be supported, h. That is, based upon the given data, we need to find out for the maximum sag, that is S equal to W into L square by 80. Here the weight of the conductor, they are given 804 into 10 to the power of minus 3 kg per meter. span length L is 220 meter. The height is constant. We need to find out for the tension. That is based upon the data. Tension T equal to ultimate tensile strength by safety factor. In the problem, they are not given for the area. If they are given, the area means ultimate tensile strength into area of the conductor by safety factor. Now, that is ultimate tensile strength is how much? 5758 by the problem, the safety factor they are given 2. We are getting the tension is 2879 kg. Now, all the data is there. You can substitute the value. That is sag S equal to WL square by 80. That is equal span length. Equal span length. The weight of the conductor is 804 into 10 to the power of 3. And the span length L is 220 square by 8 into the tension is 2879. Here we are getting the sag is 1.689 meter. As well as here we need to find out the conductor should be supported at a height of how much? That is H equal to minimum clearance plus sag. In the problem, the ground clearance or minimum clearance, they are given for 10 meter. The sag is 1.689 meter. That is total the height above the ground is 11.689 meter. In this class, we have discussed about stringing chart, sag template, conductor vibration, and the numerical problem we are calculating under equal span length, sag, as well as for the conductor should be supported above the height, that is the ground clearance plus sag.